Hello, this is James Pickles, Fasten Safeti product owner. In this video, I'm going to explain how to calculate individual risk per annum for two sets of workers on a hypothetical facility, which is a very common task in quantified risk assessment. I have Safeti open and I've loaded a study that contains a number of process areas, some storage tanks, some ignition sources, and some buildings. You can also see I've created the blue risk ranking points. These are the locations where I expect workers to be present on this facility. For some of these locations, for example, the large process areas, the risk ranking point is going to give me individual risk for the centre of the process area. If you want to be more accurate than that, you could create a number of risk ranking points across the process area and take an average of the individual risk from those risk ranking points. Five of the risk ranking points represent outdoor locations, so the ones in the orange process areas and the storage tanks, and four of the risk ranking points represent indoor building locations, so the blue rectangles on the map. In this study, I have the 3D explosion license, which means on the map tab, I can create different building types and assign each type a building vulnerability. In other words, I can vary the vulnerability based on the building's design. You can see in this study, I'm using the building types defined in the CIA Occupied Buildings Guidance from the UK, and I've created one building for each building type. Over on the risk tab, I've created a building vulnerability object for each CIA category. If you don't have the 3D license, you'll be restricted to the indoor vulnerability, which doesn't offer as much flexibility. So let's get to the results. From the risk icon in the ribbon, I can select the individual risk ranking grid report. And this will provide me with individual risk estimates for each risk ranking point. In other words, the location specific individual risk. I've prepared a spreadsheet where I'm going to calculate the individual risk per annum from the LSIR results. So you can see in this spreadsheet, I've entered the names of the risk ranking points, building A, B, C and D, and outside areas A, B, C, D and E. So I need to extract the LSIR results from Safeti for each of these risk ranking points and enter them into the spreadsheet. One thing to note is that Safeti will calculate individual risk for all vulnerabilities for each risk ranking point, even if some of those vulnerabilities for a given risk ranking point are not of interest to you. So when you're extracting the numbers, you'll need to think about the relevant vulnerability for each risk ranking point. We can see on the map tab that building A is a CIA 1 building type. So the relevant LSIR from this table is 3.986 times 10 to the minus 8. So we need to enter that value into the spreadsheet. From the map tab, we can see that building B is a CIA 2 building type. So the relevant in LSIR from this table is 7.943 times 10 to the minus 6. So we enter that value into the spreadsheet. For the outdoor areas, the relevant vulnerability is the outdoor vulnerability object. So you would enter this value into the spreadsheet. So you would repeat this process for all risk ranking points, like I've done on this second worksheet. Then in the QRA, you would define some worker categories. So for example, here I've defined maintenance workers and operations workers. For each category of worker, you should define the number of hours per day they spend in each area. And then also you should define the number of days per year that they are on the facility. The reason we need to know this is because individual risk per annum is equal to location specific individual risk multiplied by exposure, where exposure is the proportion of the year that the individual is present in the specified location. So then in the individual risk per annum calculation in row 9, we can see that individual risk per annum is equal to LSIR multiplied by the number of hours per day divided by 24, multiplied by the number of days per year, divided by 365. You would repeat that calculation across all areas on the site. Then The total individual risk per annum for the maintenance workers is the sum of the individual risk per annum across all of the areas on the facility. Similarly, for the operations workers, the total individual risk per annum would be the sum of the individual risk per annum across all of the site areas. And that's it. It's very simple to do. It requires risk ranking points to be defined for each area on the site, and then extraction of the relevant individual risks from the individual risk ranking grid report, combined with information about the presence of workers on the site to give individual risk per annum. Thank you for listening, and if you have any questions or would like to get in touch, please email digital@dnvgl.com.